Hello students, so now we'll talk about the uses of concave mirror. But you know, before discussing the uses of concave mirror, I just want to draw a chart so that it becomes more clear and easy to understand, like where the image will be formed, you know, how it will be changing with the change in the position of the object. So you know, like just we'll talk about the chart which will give a clear and easy indications of the image formation, right. So now first of all, the first column will be the position of the object then position of the image and we have got how many 6 image formation we have seen, right. We have seen 6 image formation. So like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 and definitely now here one more column will be there. Size of the image and then nature of the image, nature of the image, right. So here we are talking about one chart, one, you know, easy way to understand and to locate the image position. And this will be the last one, alright. So if you all remember that diagram, okay, which shows like where we have kept the different, you know, different places, at different places we have kept the object, isn't it. So a concave mirror M dash XY principal axis, right, here pole, focus, curvature, right. So first of all, in the first column we will fill up the entries like position of the object, like where, at what all different positions were there and where the objects were kept, what were the different positions of the object, right. Now so that is the reason I have drawn this diagram. The first position was where, what did I say that day in that lecture also, like before this. So we are going to move, like our object will be moving this side. So this will be our first position, this will be our second position, we are moving, isn't it. Then third position, then fourth position, fifth position and somewhere else sixth position. What is the first position? That means the between the pole and the focus. So just I'll write it over here. The first position is between the pole and focus, right. Then definitely we are shifting our object, okay, towards the left hand side. So first the object was here between the pole and the focus, or focus and the pole, then definitely it is going to come on where, it is going to come on the focus. So second, on the focus, right. Then between the, see this is the second position, after this again we are moving this side. So now what will be the next position? Between the curvature and the focus, or between the focus and the curvature. So next position will be between the focus and curvature, right. After this, on the curvature, on the curvature, center of curvature, then beyond curvature, and then at infinity, right. We are moving this side. First we have kept the object between these two points. See, this is pole, this is in, this is a mirror, concave mirror M dash, the principal axis XY, this is pole, focus, curvature, right? So the first time the object has to be kept between these two position, between the focus and the pole, then we will keep it on the focus, then between the curvature and the focus, then on the curvature, then beyond curvature, and then at infinity, right? Now what will happen when, first of all, I have given all the details like where the object we will be keeping, where it has to be kept. Now when the objects are kept in this way, definitely what we are doing, we are moving with our object, like our object is moving this side. So definitely the image formation will move this side. Only the first case is a different kind of a case. It is an exceptional case where, you know, the image is also formed behind the mirror. That just try to recall all images what we have done, isn't it? So here only the first case, if we talk about, it will be formed behind the mirror, right? It will be formed behind the mirror. And when we talk about the size of the image, okay, like what will be the size of the image? So the first case, if you remember, the size was highly enlarged, so it was enlarged. Yeah, the first case was enlarged. And behind the mirror, whenever the image will be formed, so it will be virtual. And whenever the virtual image is formed, then it will be definitely erect also. So the first case is very, very clear that when the object is kept between the pole and the focus, the image will be formed behind the mirror and it will be enlarged, highly enlarged actually. Then virtual image will be formed and then the virtual image will be erect. Okay, all this we have discussed, like always the virtual image will be erect. Now wrist, now from here if we see, so image, as the object will be moving towards the left hand side, okay, as the object will be moving towards the left hand side, it is going to move towards the right hand side. So when it is on the focus, when the object is on the focus, the image will be formed at infinity. Now one thing very clear, that this is a, you know, vice versa case, that when the object is on the focus, the image will be formed on the infinity. When the object is at infinity, then it will be formed at the focus, at focus, right? So now the second is between the focus and the curvature. So when the object is kept between the focus and the curvature, so the image formation was on, like it was formed beyond the curvature. Then when it was on the center of curvature, right, when we kept the object on the center of curvature, the image formation also took place on the center of curvature. Center of curvature. Right? Now when the object was kept on, you know, like beyond curvature, so what will happen? So here in this case, the image was formed between focus and curvature. You know, if you just try to go like this, okay, when the image is going, moving towards the left, you will find, you know, your image is moving towards the right hand side. You just leave the first one, just try to see, first one infinity, then beyond curvature, on the curvature, between the focus and curvature, between the focus and curvature, on the focus, or at the focus, at the focus. So what I am telling is, like when the object is moving this side, when the object is moving this side, the image will move towards this side. Whenever the virtual image formation will takes place, the image will be erect, okay? And only the first case is a little different one, but now here when we talk about all the other images, all other images are, which kind of images, children? All the images were real and inverted. All images were real and inverted, right? All the images which were formed were real and inverted. Now here also, if we talk about the first one, okay, just this one I'm leaving. We are discussing from the second, position. Now, from the second position, you know, when we talk about the size of the image also, it is decreasing. You know, it is very easy to understand like how the image formation is changing. So first of all, it is, you know, very big image is formed here. So I'll write highly enlarged. Now, after highly large, enlarge, like it is again becoming small because highly large and then enlarge. So, enlarge. After enlarge, then on the center of curvature, it will be of the same size. Then diminished. And then highly diminished. So actually this chart is very easy, you know, it becomes very easy to understand with the help of this chart. What we have done, we have kept the object at different places, and while changing the position of the object, we are moving towards the left hand side. It was first between the focus and the pole, then focus, then the center of curvature and the focus, then center of curvature, then beyond curvature and then at the infinity. As our object is moving towards the left hand side, our image will be moving towards the right hand side. Now, only the first case is little different that you have to, you know, I'm trying to teach you the way to learn the positions, like, because sometimes, you know, many of the students get confused. They are not able to remember that where the image formation will take place, and during the exam time they are not, like, you know, sometimes they make certain silly mistakes regarding the position. So even if you make a rough chart of this and then you can go for the images, it becomes more easy. Only the first case is different, where enlarged image is formed behind the mirror. Here the image will be formed, and whenever the the image formation takes place behind the mirror, definitely it is shown by the dotted lines and virtual image is formed. This is all explained to you. And whenever the virtual image formation takes place, that image is what? It is erect. Now, wrist, very easy to learn, understand all the images which is formed in concave mirror, other than the first one, when the position is between the pole and the focus, all the time the images will be real and inverted, right? It will be real, but it will be inverted. Now, and here it is very first column I'm leaving because it is enlarged image is formed, that we are leaving now. Highly enlarged, then, like, you know what is happening, the size of the image is becoming smaller and smaller. So it is highly enlarged, then enlarge, then it is of same size, then diminish and highly diminished. So what is happening? Just try to understand this thing and try to keep this thing in your mind, so it will become easy to, you know, learn all this thing. So here when we talk about this chart, the image is becoming smaller and smaller as we move towards the next positions. Now, this is just vice versa of the column which we have kept. Where the position of the images, the object is, it is, we are moving in this way, and here we are going to move in this way. So behind the mirror, the first case is the exceptional case, and definitely from then afterwards we have to see from here, right? So focus, we have discussed this thing n number of times, that it is vice versa, you know, formation takes place, with that when the object is on the focus, the image will form on the infinity. When the object is on the infinity, then the image formation will take place on the focus, right? So this is a simple chart which makes the image formation ray diagrams easy. Now we are going to talk about the uses of the concave mirror, right? So now what are the uses of the concave mirror? Okay, so we'll talk about now uses of the concave mirror. Right, now what are the uses of the concave mirror? See, first of all, first point, we have discussed this thing, like when the object is kept within the focus, right? When the object is kept within the focus, before the focus, so what is happening? The enlarged image is formed. The enlarged image is formed due to this property, due to this formation of the enlarged image. The concave mirror is used as the shaving mirrors. They are used as the shaving mirrors because when the object is kept within the focus, when we keep our face very near to the mirror, then enlarged image is formed. It becomes easy to go for the shaving, even for the makeup mirrors, you know, when certain kind of makeup has to be done. The you know concave mirror is used, and when in concave mirror, when we you know when we bring that mirror very close, so it becomes easy to apply the makeups clearly. So even the makeup mirror is used. Now the second one is the dentist use. It is also known as dentist mirror. Now what is happening now? See, whenever you go to dentist, what they use? They just use a mirror which they you know keep inside the mouth, and they are able to see the reflection in that. Now what is happening, that mirror is very small, but it has got a big handle so that it can be kept inside the mouth and can be seen. So here also what is happening, children, the object is kept very near within the focus, again within the focus, and so a large image will be formed, and so the bigger image of your teeth will be seen, and it will become easy to understand for the doctor and to work upon it. Right, now the third is the it is used in solar cookers. See, one property, very specific property of the concave mirror, that these are converging mirrors, isn't it? These are which kind of mirror, children? These are converging mirrors. They converge. Now as we have all studied about the converging mirrors and the diverging mirrors, so I think this should be very clear. Converging means like coming together, isn't it? All the rays come together, all the parallel rays are, you know, this concave mirror has the property to bring all the concave mirror after the reflection to you know it get focused on one point only, it comes on the focus. So due to solar cooker, you know, the different parallel rays which are falling on that particular furnace cooker, so due to concave mirror, this you know rays which are falling at different places, after reflection they all come and meet at one place, right? They all come and meet at one place like this, and so this place, you know what happens, the strong light falls, the heat get increased, and many a times for steel melting of steel, even for melting of steel, the this one concave mirrors are used, right? But that means what I mean to say is the temperature get increased so much, and why does the temperature get increased so much? Because of the converging nature of the concave mirror. So again, here it is used in solar cooker. Then after this, it is also used in dishes. You know, concave dishes are used actually. Concave dishes are used in TV antenna. You know, actually what is happening here also, you know, when these, you know, when we talk about the signals which are catched you know by the concave dishes which comes from the satellite, right? See what I'm saying, the signals which comes out from the satellite are not the light rays, they are not the light rays, but still due to concave dishes, what happen, they all like, you know, it has the capability to bring all the parallel rays together, and then it get reflected and get converged. So again this property of, you know, converging property of concave mirror is very very important. Due to this, again what is happening, all the signals get converged in one point, right? Now along with this, it is also used in reflectors. Now when we talk about reflectors, or you know the torch, or even the, you know, the searchlight, right? So what is happening, we have done this, like, you know, when the object is kept, right, when the object is kept, when the bulb is kept on the focus, so what happened, like on the focus, that means when the object is kept on the focus, so due to the convergence, a very strong beam of light will be you know emerge, will be coming out from these kinds of torches, reflectors and searchlights, so it become easy to focus at different distances, right? It goes to a long distance, and it becomes easy, like these all becomes very very useful. Now next one, sixth one, it is also used, concave mirrors are also used by the doc, like in the doctor's head mirror, right? It is used by doctors in their head mirror. Now if you have ever seen, like, doctors, you know, while operating, when they have to see, you know, the internal parts, like you know the internal structure of the maybe the nose, throat, you know. So what happens, they use one particular big, you know, like not so big, but like, you know, mirror over here, they tie it over here, and it again, as the concave mirrors are the converging mirror, it a strong beam of light can be, you know, it comes out from the, you know, these kind of, you know, the whatever mirror they have placed with the torches and all. So due to which it becomes easy for the doctors to see the patients different, the, you know, problem like eyes, whatever you talk about, the nose and the these parts. So it is also used in the doctor head mirrors. So these all are the uses of the concave mirror. Always remember, the uses depends upon their nature. The uses of the concave mirror is due to their nature, that the, you know, what is happening, the enlarged images are formed, right? Enlarged images are formed, and the you know, it is of converging nature. Due to this convergence, the strong beams can be you know, emitted from the torches and searchlights. So always remember, we'll talk about, you know, in the when we'll discuss about the convex mirror, then we'll discuss about like how we can understand like which mirror is there in our hand, whether it is a plane, it is a concave or convex mirror. It all depends upon their property, how do they show the images. So this was the column, this was the chart which shows the different positions of the object, then the different positions where the images will be formed, the nature of the image, like what, how, which kind of nature of, you know, which kind of image will be formed, and definitely along with the size also. Now here we have discussed about the different kind of uses of concave mirror. Now we'll talk about the convex mirror. First of all, we'll talk about, like, you know, different positions at the convex mirror, then we'll discuss about the rule of the image formation on the convex mirror, and then we'll discuss about the various images, image formation which are formed due to the or by the convex mirror, right? Okay, so now we'll talk about the rules of the image formation, rules of the image formation in convex mirror. Right. So now, till you know, this time we have discussed concave mirror, the image formation rules, like what are the rules of the image formation in the concave mirror, and we have also discussed about their uses. Now we'll be discussing about the convex mirror, the rules of the image formation by the convex mirror. So first of all, when we talk about the convex mirror, children, so again here we have got four rules. Right, we'll be discussing about the four rules, right? So now we'll talk about first of all the first rule. Now, whenever I draw a convex mirror, right? Whenever we draw a convex mirror, so definitely it is polished from this side, and the bulgy part is the reflecting surface, right? Now, this is again like the x and y is the principal axis, m dash. The reflecting surface. Now, one very important point, children, like when we talk about the convex mirror, the focus, right, the focus in the curvature of the convex mirror are behind the mirror. The focus and the curvature of the convex mirror are behind the mirror. Now try to understand, children, no light rays. This is our mirror, this is our reflecting, this one is reflecting surface and this one is the polished surface. Now children, no rays can pass through the polished surface, right? It is polished, so it cannot go that side. So now whatever images we'll be drawing behind the mirror, we'll all will be showing it with the help of the dotted line. And whenever we talk about the dotted line, it is all the virtual, you know, rays. We do not actually have rays, you know, the rays are not going behind the mirror, the rays are not formed behind the mirror, but it appears to be like that, you know. We have discussed this thing in detail when we had discussed about the virtual and the real images. So just remember, in the convex mirror, whatever images, you know, whatever the here the rays will be formed in the dotted form, these all will be virtual rays, right? Because no rays in reality can go, reality can go behind the mirrors. Now the first case where the, you know, the ray coming parallel, right? This is mm dash, the reflecting surface, the mirror. This is xy, the principal axis, focus and the center of curvature. Now, if a ray of light which comes parallel, okay, A and B, a ray of light which comes parallel, which falls parallelly, which is parallel to the principal axis, you know, it incident at this point and it get reflected, right? And it get reflected. So first of all, very important thing, we have to put the arrows. So a parallel beam of light A and B, AB, okay, it comes and get incident on this reflecting surface and get reflected. So I have to put this side arrow as BD. So incident ray is AB and the reflected ray will be BD. But now, you know, the person who is towards the left hand side, the person who is seeing this from the left hand side, you know what will happen? This ray will appear to come from the focus, right? This will be, and so I have used this dotted structure over here, like not structure, dotted lines over here. So what is the first rule? Whenever the, see the rules are same only, okay, so whenever a parallel beam, whenever the parallel ray incident on the reflecting surface, after reflection it appears to come from the focus, right? In concave mirror it comes from the focus, and really it comes from the really it comes from the focus, but here this, it appears to come from the focus, right? So this is the parallel ray to the principal axis, it get reflected and go in the other direction, but then when we see it from here, so it appears that this is coming from the focus. So what is the first rule? A parallel ray of light where it incident on the reflecting surface, after reflection it appears to come from the focus, right? Now we'll talk about the second rule. Now when we talk about the second rule, children, the second rule is, again, first of all, the convex mirror M dash, principal axis x, y, and focus and curvature. Now, when a ray of light, you know, it passes, it takes the path of the center of curvature, right? So what happens? It appears to come from the center of curvature. Now I'll explain it again. This one is our real line. This is not the dotted line, because this is the line which is coming now really. Now see, two things are there. Okay, I'll restart this. See, what is happening over here is, when a ray of light, okay, when a ray of light, this is A and B. Right, now please try to understand over here. Now when the ray of light A and B is moving towards the this reflecting surface mirror, it passing through the, you know, takes the path of the center of curvature, so this is the incident ray, okay, but then it get reflect, okay, it is getting reflected, it is following the same path again. So it has, this line has got two lines actually, one the this real ray and again the reflected ones, now because from this path again it has followed the same path, so it has come back to following the same path. So children, AB will be incident, isn't it, incident ray, and BA will be reflected ray, right? So AB will be incident ray, it will follow the same path, it will trace the same path and it will come back. So BA will be the reflected path. Now what actually is happening over here, children? Here this, you know, it appears to come from the center of the curvature, and so it is being, I have drawn over here with a dotted line. I'll again show it, like, you know, it, when a ray of light falls, you know, it takes the path of the center of the curvature. When a ray of light, you know, it goes towards the center of curvature of the convex mirror, so it get reflected, it follows the same path, right? And when we try to, you know, find out, when we try to see it from the left hand side, it appears to come from the center of the curvature, right? So this is again the second rule. Now why this one is, you know, why this, when this light ray falls, you know, an incident on the point B, why has this ray taken the same path? Because children, this AB has, ray AB is falling perpendicularly, okay, on this axis, and so here the angle of incidence and angle of reflection will be zero. Like, you know, this one is also explained in the concave mirror. So the second rule is also same, that when the ray of light, it follows the path to the center of curvature, it, you know, it get reflected on a particular point and it is traced, it traces, it comes back by the same point, okay, it comes back following the same path and it appears to come from the center of the curvature from the left hand side. Now the third rule, is, children, the opposite of this rule, isn't it? So again, M dash principal axis and focus and the curvature, right? Now the first rule is what? That when the ray of light which is parallel to principal axis after reflection appears to come from the focus. Now when a ray of light, okay, when a ray of light, when it comes, you know, like this, I am taking one, this ray of light, okay, I can name it as AB, okay. Now AB is a ray which is coming from a point, you know, following the path of the focus, then after reflection it becomes parallel to the principal axis. After reflection what will happen? It will become parallel to the principal axis. So AB is the incident ray, okay. AB incident ray is AB, but reflected ray is what? BD, right? And it appears to come from the focus, right? And that is the reason I have drawn this with the dotted line, because in real, you know, real case, it is not going from, you know, coming inside the polished surface, going behind the mirror, but that when one, you know, when we see from this side, this ray of light appears to come from the focus, and after, you know, coming from the focus, it get reflected. This arrow I have put wrong over here, children. Now this will be actually a ray of light which is coming from the focus. See here, what we have drawn here, the ray of light is coming from this side. It was right. So when a ray of light comes from this path which follows the focus actually, then it get, after reflection becomes parallel, and when we try to meet it, so where we are going to, where we are going to bring this rays to the focus, because we know that the rays coming from the focus get reflected and after reflection it becomes parallel to the principal axis, right? So ray of light which is now here, no, it appears to come from the focus, after reflection get, you know, parallel to the principal axis. So this ray of light coming, incident point is here, and get reflected as the parallel, you know, parallel to the principal axis, and we have to extend it towards the focus, right? Now the last rule, okay, the fourth rule is, again we have to draw a mirror. MM dash is a mirror, then XY is the principal axis, right? Then here the focus and curvature, right? This is our rough diagram which is ready. Now here we have to show the you know, the rays. Now a ray of light, okay, a ray of light which falls on the pole, okay, it makes the same, and it makes the, you know, angle of incidence which this with this principal axis, right? See again, a ray of light which incident on the pole, okay, this is pole everywhere, this is pole, So a ray of light which falls, which incidents on the pole, after reflection it makes the angle of reflection with the principal axis. So both the angles are formed, this ray of light A B. So this ray of light AB, which incidents on the point B or P, we should say, it makes the angle of incidence with the principal axis, isn't it? This is the angle of incidence. So what will be this angle? A, I'll have to write here B, ABX. So ABX is the angle of incidence, and Now angle of reflection, if we talk about, so it will be what? It will be X and B, and here I can write X D, right? So XBD are the angle of XB. See this one, A, B and X, this is the incident angle, and again X, B and D will be the angle of reflection. You can, you know, without writing this point B, you can take the point P also. So here the equal angle of incidence and reflection will be formed. So this is again what it says, like when the ray of light falls on this point, on the P, on the pole, it get reflected making the same angle that of incidence. That means here the angle of incidence and angle of reflection will be same. So these are the four rules. Okay, the first one is what? A parallel ray. Okay, just now I'll write down now, a ray of light which is parallel, a ray of light, there is no place now, which is parallel to principal axis will appear to come from focus, right? Like a ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis, it appears after reflection, it appears to come from the focus, right? Now here what is happening? A ray of light is following the path of the center of curvature. A ray of light going towards the center of curvature follows the same path. Right? Then the third one is a ray of light towards the focus becomes parallel to the principal axis after reflection. Right? And now the fourth one, that when a ray of light incidents at pole, it get reflected making the same angle of reflection, making the equal incident and reflected angle. So here, right, so making the same angle of reflection with, also I will write with principal axis. These rules are same as the concave mirrors rule, right? there also when the ray of light you know it is parallel to the principal axis, it will you know after reflection pass through the focus. Here it is appearing to do that. A ray of light which comes you know falls on the center of curvature, passes through the center of curvature, it will again take the same path, right? Here also it is happening. A ray of light incidenting over here, it appears to come from the center of curvature and it takes the same path and it falls perpendicularly. So the same path is being followed by the ray. Now third one, when the ray of light comes from the focus, it get reflected and becomes parallel to the principal axis. Same here, a ray of light which appears to come from the focus after reflection get parallel, becomes parallel to this. And here a ray of light which is falling on this point P makes the angle of incidence and it get reflected, making the same angle of reflection with the principal axis. So these are the rules of the image formation of the convex mirror. Now we'll see which kind of images are formed by the convex mirror, right? So please note this. Now we'll talk about the images of the convex mirror.